Our study today is entitled, Jesus Preached to the Spirits in Prison. Apostle Peter wrote that in the writings of Apostle Paul, there are some things which are hard to be understood. He wrote it in his second epistle. Ironically, this passage that Peter wrote in 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 18 to 20, is one of the hardest to be understood in Scripture. Many people have misunderstood Peter badly. Let's read what Peter wrote in 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 18 to 20. For Christ also hath once suffered for sins, the just for the unjust, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but quickened by the Spirit, by which also he went and preached unto the spirits in prison, which sometime were disobedient when once the long-suffering of God waited in the days of Noah, while the ark was a preparing, wherein few, that is, eight souls were saved by water. Most of the people don't carefully read what the apostle wrote. When you read it superficially, you might get a different message. For example, let me only read the highlighted words. Christ, being put to death, went and preached unto the spirits in prison in the days of Noah. So if you read this without studying it properly, it would mean that when Jesus died on Good Friday and between his death and resurrection, he went and preached the gospel to the people who died in the flood during Noah's days. This is how most of the Christians interpret that passage and conclude that the dead people's souls or spirits are alive and they can be preached to. To understand this passage clearly, we will ask three questions and see for the answer from the passage itself and take help from other parts of Scripture. Question number one, to whom did Jesus preach? Question number two, how did Jesus preach? And question number three, when did Jesus preach? Let's start with the first question, to whom did Jesus preach? I will only read the highlighted words. He went and preached unto the spirits in prison. Normally we think the word spirits refer to the dead people, but the word spirit in the Greek dictionary of the Bible has several meanings. One of the meanings in the Strong's Greek dictionary is spirit, mental disposition. So the mental disposition is the reasoning power of man. In the Bible also, you see in many verses where spirit and mind are interlinked. For example, in Philippians 1:27, that he stand fast in one spirit with one mind. So one spirit means one mind, therefore spirit means mind in the Bible as well. And also in 2 Timothy 1:7, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. Again, you see, spirit is connected with the mind. Beloved, our spiritual battle between Christ and Satan, between good and evil, is fought in the thoughts of our mind. Isn't that right? Also, Paul tells us in 2 Corinthians 10:5, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Beloved, the imagination and every thought happens in the human mind. God wants us to cast down our strong negative imaginations, the wrong imaginations, and bring every thought of our mind to the obedience of Christ and surrender every thinking to Jesus Christ. Paul wrote elsewhere in Romans 12 and verse 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of our mind. Beloved, our mind has to be renewed every day. It has to be transformed. We have to give our thoughts to Jesus. Through Isaiah, God said in Isaiah 1:18, "Come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord." Yes, beloved, God appeals to our mind, to our reasoning capacity, and He says, choose the right way. Since the topic of Apostle Peter's discussion was about the people in Noah's days, let us see what Moses recorded of their imaginations and their thoughts. In Genesis 6 and verse 5, "And God saw the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually." Here it says, every imagination of their thoughts was only evil continually. They had no room for God, no room for the gospel message that Noah was preaching. Peter wrote, "The spirits were in prison." Now, prison is used in the Bible symbolically to describe the slavery to sin. The earth is one big prison house. All are sinners on this earth, bound by sin to die. But Jesus came to set us free from the prison house of sin. The work of Jesus was foretold by Isaiah the prophet in Isaiah 61 verse 1. "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound." So, beloved, Jesus came to set prisoners free in the prison house of sin. He came to set them free. Jesus, remember, said later, "If the Son makes you free, you are free indeed." And how would Jesus do it? It's the Spirit of the Lord. Through the Spirit of the Lord, He would do it. So to whom did Jesus preach? He preached to the prisoners of sin in Noah's days in this context. Now we'll go to our second question. How did Jesus preach? I will only read the highlighted words. "By the Spirit, He went and preached." Now here it says, Jesus was quickened by the Spirit. Quickened means to be made alive or resurrected by the Spirit. Paul also tells us the same thing, how Jesus was resurrected from the dead. In Romans 8:11, "The Spirit of Him that raised up Jesus from the dead." So, by the Spirit, Jesus went and preached means by the Holy Spirit, Jesus did the preaching. Isaiah also said the same thing in Isaiah 61 verse 1. "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He hath anointed me to preach." Jesus and the Holy Spirit, they work very closely together. Jesus Himself said in John chapter 16 verses 13 and 14, "Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all truth, for He will not speak of Himself, but whatsoever He shall hear, that shall He speak, and He will show you things to come. He shall glorify Me, for He shall receive of Mine and show it unto you." Jesus and the Holy Spirit, they work together. The Holy Spirit only speaks what He hears from Jesus, according to this passage. Let's go to Noah's time and see if Jesus and the Holy Spirit were working together. Genesis 6 and verse 3. "And the Lord said, My Spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he is also flesh, yet his day shall be 120 years. The Lord here is Jesus, and My Spirit is the Holy Spirit. For 120 years, Jesus through the Holy Spirit was preaching to the people in Noah's days. Peter himself, in the same epistle of 1 Peter, talked about how the Spirit of Christ was working through the prophets of the Old Testament. 1 Peter 1:10, "The prophets, the Spirit of Christ, which was in them." So, how did Jesus preach to the people in Noah's days? Through the Holy Spirit, Jesus spoke to all of them. We'll go to our question number 3. When did Jesus preach? I'll just read the highlighted passage again. He went and preached while the ark was preparing. While the ark was preparing, the flood still did not come. It came only after 120 years. It was at this time, while Noah was preparing the ark during 120 years, Jesus, through the Holy Spirit, was preaching through Noah. And how many responded to the preaching? It says 8 souls were saved by water. So Jesus did not do the preaching to some dead souls of Noah's flood, but to the living prisoners of sin before the flood came. Even if you think Jesus preached to the lost people of Noah's flood after they died to give them another chance, then you still have a problem. Then you have to conclude God is a partial God. Think about this. Why should God give only one generation of people in Noah's time a second chance to be saved, and not to the people of Sodom and Gomorrah, who perished in even a more terrible way, destruction by fire? Also, what about all the people who died till then? Why didn't Jesus give them another chance and preach to them? The Bible is clear, beloved, in Isaiah 38:18, they that go down into the pit cannot hope for thy truth. So where was Jesus for those 3 days? Listen to the angels who were guarding the tomb. They should know best. They told the women on Easter Sunday morning in Matthew chapter 28, 5 and 6, and the angel answered and said unto the women, "Fear not, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay." From this verse, we are told by the angel 2 things: where Jesus was during these 3 days, and what Jesus was doing there. Where was Jesus? The angel said, "Come, see the place." The angel invited them inside the tomb. So Jesus was in the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea for 3 days. And what was Jesus doing there for the 3 days? It says here, the Lord lay. Jesus was lying down or sleeping for 3 days. So Jesus was not preaching during the 3 days to some dead spirits. The dead know nothing, the Bible says in Ecclesiastes 9:5. So how can one preach to them? Also, their probation closes at death. Jesus, beloved, preached to living people and appealed to their minds, which is also called spirit. He preached for 120 years during Noah's time by the Holy Spirit while Noah was preparing the ark. And also Jesus, through the Spirit, was preaching to every person in every generation through the Spirit, wanting them to be delivered from the captivity and prisoners of sin. And in Noah's days, only 8 people finally responded to the message and were saved when God brought his judgment through the flood. That's about Jesus preached to the spirits in prison. Thank you, and God bless. Amen.